Newborn babies love to be swaddled. It helps them feel more secure, but it can feel a little bit like origami to mums and dads at first. So here's our midwife, Jo. She'll tell you how it's done.
First of all, you get a piece of material that is of natural fibres, and you put the baby in the centre. It has to be square in order for it to work. So you put the baby in the middle with the head just literally over the top of the fabric, and you place the arm close to its chest, close to its side, and you literally just wrap it right over and secure it under the bottom. Straighten it so that nothing gets sort of hitched up, because obviously the lumps and bumps will be uncomfortable. Then you fold up the fabric, put the baby's arm again close to its side, and again bring it right over and secure it around the bottom. And then this piece fits right underneath, and that stays then, and the baby's arms and legs and everything are nice and secure.
And they feel nice and happy like that?
Yeah, they just get a lot of comfort for being sort of in a close situation, just like they are really inside their mummy's tummy.
And do you reckon they'd sleep for longer if they're swaddled?
I don't know about longer, but I know certainly they are more settled, yes.
I did swaddle Jobin, yes, I swaddled him from birth. He found it really comforting as well when he was sleeping, but as he's got a bit bigger, he wriggles more, his arms are coming out, and so it's quite difficult now. And plus he's gone into his own cot now, so he's got a bit more room. He wouldn't sleep if his arms were out. He definitely needed to feel kind of quite tight, quite cocooned, and if he ever woke up and his arms were freed and I couldn't get him to sleep, as soon as I swaddled him, bang, he was back asleep.
So after a mother swaddled her baby, how many layers do you think she should put on to let her baby sleep?
It's all about actually the temperature of the room that you put them in. You have to be very careful about overheating a baby. In order to keep them safe, and reduce the risk of cot death, you mustn't put a hat on over their head indoors. They must. You must remember that if they have a blanket or a sheet on, if you've doubled it over, then that counts as two blankets or sheets. You see time and time again babies that are really, really well wrapped up with lots of blankets and hats and everything. But babies' hands and feet will always be chilly. But if they're warm on their tummy, then they are warm